Linear functions. Okay, now the function shown here, you have a function equation, you have a table, and a graph that shows those points. Well, what if you had, say, 1.5 as an input instead of 1 or 2? Well, if you input a 1.5, multiply by 3, and then add 4, it's actually going to be halfway in between these two points. So 1.5 would be right there. And then if you did 2.5, it would be right here. 3.5, 4.5. What if you did 0? 0 would be right here. And then 0.5 would be here. And then what if I did 0.25 in between each of these halves? So if I cut it in half again, it'd be halfway in between each of these dots. And again, since it's linear, kind of following the same pattern. And what if I did 1/8, which would be halfway in between each of these 0.25s? So you see what's happening? As I plot more and more points, it's starting to fill in. And if I did more and more points and did enough, eventually you wouldn't see any gaps between the points, and it would just be one continuous line. And that's really what a linear function represents, is a continuous line. So what we do usually is we use a set of points, or inputs and outputs, to give us a guide on where that line's going to be for a linear function. And then we'll just go ahead and draw a line through there to represent that we have a linear function. And usually we'll put arrows on the ends here like this and like that to represent that the line continues in both directions. Okay, so this is really what we're talking about when we have a linear function. We have some inputs and outputs just to kind of get an idea of what the linear pattern is. But if you use any input or output besides integers, you can go ahead and fill in the line. And you don't need to make little dots like I did. You can just use a straight edge and carefully draw right through the points that you plotted.